putting together OT and IT data and making sense of that, adding some analytics to detect, for example, anomalies when a customer reports an anomaly on, you know, a product. That's something that could look cumbersome and complicated. Taylor is here today on the IoT Show to tell you exactly how you can do with, how you can do all of that with Azure Digital Twins, Azure Data Explorer, and Synapse Analytics. So don't miss that episode of the IoT Show today. Hi everyone, thanks for joining the IoT Show. I'm Olivier, your host, and today we'll talk about data. And more specifically, we'll talk about reconciling data from the OT world and the IT world. And for that, we have Taylor. Taylor, how are you?
Good, how are you, Olivier?
I'm great, I'm fantastic. So people might not know you if they have not seen previous episodes about Azure Digital Twins with you. We'll definitely invite them to go watch these previous episodes, but still, Who is Taylor, and what are you doing at Microsoft?
Sure. My name is Taylor Anderson, and I'm a product manager with the Azure Digital Twins team. I focus on building integrations between Azure Digital Twins and other services like Azure Data Explorer. And I also focus on ensuring the needs of our manufacturing customers are reflected in our roadmap.
So one of the things that customers are asking for when it comes to IoT is to reconcile data from the world of OT, from the world of operations, or what we call sometimes IoT, actually, and the world of IT, the data coming from CRM, ERPs, and so on. But can you give us some more clarification around OT and IT? You know, it was kind of a high level that I provided here, but can you tell me more about this differentiation here?
Absolutely, and I've got a slide actually covering this topic. So, when we talk about OT data, we're really talking about IoT data, or data that's coming from sensors or devices, for example, on a manufacturing line or a manufacturing execution system. When we're talking about IT data, a lot of times we're talking about data that's coming from an ERP or CRM system, something like Dynamics or SAP or Salesforce. And the challenge is that a lot of times this data lives in fundamentally different systems, so it's effectively siloed. And a core challenge that we hear from customers is that they need to reason across both of these data sets to answer big picture business questions like how to improve efficiency or reduce defects.
Got it. I just understood right now the silo pun right here. Love it. Perfect. Thanks, Taylor. That definitely clarifies it. Different silos, and you need to reconcile that. So how do you propose to do that?
Well, on this next slide here, we actually have a data flow that shows the solution that we put together here, and we're going to have a demo of this in a minute. But what we have here is we have on the right-hand side an Azure Synapse workspace, and we can ingest IT and OT data into this Synapse workspace where we can combine it and reason across it. So if we look at these different data flows here, we've got ERP data flowing into our Synapse workspace. And Synapse offers connections with a variety of popular ERP and CRM packages. We've got our manufacturing execution system data flowing into the Synapse workspace. And then we also have telemetry coming from our manufacturing line that's flowing through Azure Digital Twins, where it's contextualized, and then flowing into Azure Data Explorer using the data history feature. So we're actually historizing all of the updates to Azure Digital Twins. So we have a complete historical record for all of the digital twins, and then we can combine and reason across all this data within Synapse.
Okay, I love it. Let's try and make it a bit more real here. Tell me about a use case. I know you prepared a use case that explains, you know, all of that, because that's a lot of bits and pieces put together. I want to understand that better.
Yeah, so imagine Alice, she's a production manager at Contoso Inc., and she gets a complaint regarding a batch of widgets that were shipped last week. And so she needs to do an investigation to understand the cause for the quality issue. And so to do that, she has a purchase order number. But to perform the investigation, she needs to reason across not only the purchase order information, but also the production information so she can understand where this order was fulfilled, where it was manufactured, when it was manufactured, and then even drill down further to look at the manufacturing line and the stations on that line that were responsible for fulfilling that order. She wants to be able to look at the telemetry emitted by the very stations on the line that manufactured the widgets that were sent to the customer.
Okay, how does it look like from the data perspective, right? If I'm a data person, I want to see, you know, diagrams with database and so on. There you go.
Yeah, so here's the overall data model for our example scenario. And we're starting off in the upper left corner where we have a purchase order ID. And if we have a purchase order, then we can then look that purchase order up in the purchase order table, which comes to us from SAP in this example we're going to see. Mm-hmm. And once we look up that purchase order, we can then look up the plant code, the plant where that purchase order was fulfilled, and then we can look up that particular production schedule. Once we have the production schedule for the purchase order, we can then look up the manufacturing line. And so at that point, that leads us into our Azure Digital Twins block here, and we have the plant code and the manufacturing line. So we can run a query in Azure Digital Twins to then look up the stations on the line that were responsible for manufacturing the widgets. And then, of course, because we're using the data history feature, we actually have the time series telemetry associated with those stations during that manufacturing period. Which then allows us to do things like time series analytics on the stations that were responsible for fulfilling that purchase order.
Got it. I see. So basically getting data from one source, getting data from another source, getting data from your operations, the IoT sensors and devices, asset tracking and so on, putting all of that into Digital Twins to make sense of that data together, and then using ADX to explore the data and its history. In a nutshell.
Exactly. Yeah, I have the example and we can walk through
Let's walk through the actual demo.
All right, great. So I'm going to jump over to my web browser. Okay, so now I'm in Azure Synapse Analytics. I've created a Synapse workspace here and I've got a few tabs here. I've set all these tabs up beforehand. But the first tab we're going to look at here is a pipeline. And what this pipeline does is it takes a table and copies it into a file. And it does that, and I can do that by defining the source for my pipeline. So you can see here, I've defined an SAP table resource. This is a linked service. So I'm gonna copy a specific table from SAP. And then I'm only gonna copy the fields I care about. And then I also define the sync. So in this case here, the sync is going to be a JSON table that lives within a storage account that's accessible to my Synapse workspace. So this is the pipeline for moving a table in from my ERP. In this case, it happens to be SAP.
And what is the kind of data you're retrieving? Is it the purchase orders, right?
Yeah, so okay. A great question. The next tab here actually shows what we're copying over. So this is a SQL query that I wrote, and all this query does is now that we've copied this table into a JSON file, it copies the contents of that JSON file into a view within my serverless SQL pool. And so you can see below, after it copies it into a view, it selects a few rows. So we can see here in this table, the first column is actually the purchase order ID, and then the next column is the plant code, and then some other columns as well in my purchase order table.
Okay. So now you have data from SAP. Now you need to have the production order data, right?
Exactly. So this next script here, all this does is it reaches out and it copies CSV files, which are the various production order schedules from all the different factories at Contoso Inc. So in this case here, we're looking at the production schedule for plant 3200, and we can go back in time and we can see the various purchase orders that were fulfilled by a production order. Mm-hmm. And we can also see the production line and the plant code associated with that production order.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Yeah, cool. So now you have these two tables and you need to reconcile all of that, right?
Yeah, right. So what we can do is we can effectively join these two tables, and I have a sample query here, and this is for a given purchase order ID, but all this does is it effectively says, hey, we've got this purchase order, then it resolves the plant where it was fulfilled, looks up the production schedules we saw earlier, and then provides these results. So we can see for purchase order 3,046,000, was fulfilled by this production order on production line 2 in plant 3200 in Munich.
Cool. So now Alice knows where that order should be fulfilled. And so now she can dig into, you know, the data from the factory floor to kind of know where things are at, right?
Exactly. And as we saw a little bit earlier, Alice has modeled her various production lines in Azure Digital Twins. So now I'm jumping over to Azure Digital Twins Explorer, which allows us to visualize the twin graph. And we can see here in plant 3200, we have production lines 1, production line 2, and production line 3. Now that Alice knows the production line in the plant, she can effectively run a query to find out which twins are on that line, right? So I'm effectively running a query that says, hey, we're interested in all twins in plant 3200 on line 2. We can see here we've got a robot. I'm going to organize these a little more neatly. A robot, a CNC machine that feeds a conveyor belt that feeds a robot. So we now know the stations on the line that were responsible for filling this purchase order.
Okay. So now we need to put all that together and detect the anomaly based on the historical data. So how do you do that from here?
Right. So as we mentioned earlier, we're using the data history feature, which means every time we update these twins, we're going to historize those twin updates to Azure Data Explorer. So we have a historical record of everything these twins did in the past. So I'm going to jump over here. And now I'm looking in the web client for Azure Data Explorer here. And what I've done is this is the data history table. I went out and loaded some records earlier, but we can see that in this data history table, this is basically time series records for our twins. We have a timestamp, we have the twin ID, we have a model ID, and then a key value pair, where the key value pair simply represents a twin property that changed over time. So in this case here, what we can do is we can say, hey, in our data history table, we know a time range when the production order occurred. And we'll start off by looking at the CNC twin on the manufacturing line. This is one of the three twins we identified on line 2. And we can just run this query here, and we can see that something strange happened on the day when that purchase order was fulfilled in plant 3200. And it looks like we had a spike in both fluid consumption as well as energy consumption.
Okay. Okay, so then you can determine that there's been some hiccup on the machinery here that generated the problem on the product. And you basically now you're basically connecting the dots between what the customer sees as, hey, my product is a defect, all the way down to exactly when the problem occurred and where it's coming from, and so you can like sort it out from there, right?
Exactly. And what we can do is, you know, as we've been going through this example, we've had a bunch of queries that represent each step in that data model we saw earlier. You know, if Alice has this problem come up again, or someone else wants to investigate it, what she can do is effectively create a dashboard.
Yeah, I was about to ask, because it's not your salesperson or even the operator of the machinery or the maintenance person was going to go through the data like you just did, right? So you're basically using Synapse, ADT, and ADX to create the queries. But at the end of the day, what you really want is an output, which is a dashboard that is consumable by different kind of people.
Exactly, exactly. So here we can build, for example, a drop-down menu where we can select a purchase order number and then run all of these queries that then from that purchase order tells us the production date when that purchase order was filled, the production order associated with the purchase order, the production line, the plant location, the plant code, the manufacturing stations on that production line, and then the historical time series data associated with those stations on that line when that purchase order was fulfilled.
Nice. Nice. And so someone from maintenance or from quality was looking at that. They can now say, hey, I have three customers that reported the same kind of anomalies. Can I correlate them? I will go from one to the other. And then we'll realize, hey, the telemetry from that robot arm, whatever, had the same glitch. So I suspect this is what generated that anomaly here, right?
Exactly. And so what we're doing effectively is when we take all these different queries that we've run independently, we can put them actually in a larger query here. And this query, I know there's a few lines here, but all this query does, and this query is driving the panel we saw earlier. All it is it's a CUSTO query, a KQL query that invokes a few SQL queries to resolve things like the plant location and the line ID. Then it runs an Azure Digital Twins query to get the stations on the line, and then it runs a time series query.
Everything at once in one place, pretty straightforward. Yep. So let's get back to that diagram you had, because I want to sum up, you know, what you did and with which services before we go into the call to action.
Absolutely. Here. Yeah, let me pull that up. Just give me a moment. Yeah, okay, so here's the diagram. And as we saw, we pulled in the purchase order table from SAP, and then we pulled in a production schedule, which was an Excel file. And then we also pulled in time series data. And in that final example, what we did is we actually ran a CUSTO query from within Azure Data Explorer. And what that query was able to do is it was able to reach out to our SQL pool and run some queries against the purchase order table, against the production schedule, as well as actually run a query against Azure Digital Twins. So we basically have created one large query that's able to run several subqueries all from within Azure Data Explorer.
Nice, nice, I like that. You know what, Taylor? I kind of understand better what Azure Synapse Analytics is for now. Thank you very much for that. One last question for you before I let you go. So you demonstrated the dashboard in Data Explorer, but would that be the kind of things you recommend our customers to go with, or are there other options? Once you have the queries, I guess you can build different types of dashboards, right?
Yeah. We recommend customers use whatever BI tool they're comfortable with that they use today. And the great thing about Azure Data Explorer is that it provides integrations with a variety of different popular BI tools out there. So it integrates with Power BI, it integrates with Phonic, it integrates with Tableau. So if you decide, hey, you know, we like to build our dashboards in one of these different products, you could do that easily. And then just use that as the front end for the query that's actually running within Azure Data Explorer.
Perfect, Taylor, that's brilliant. You wrote a blog post on the IoT blog, I have the link here on my t-shirt. So we will like to send people down there. So there's a link we're gonna bring up down here that will send you to the blog from Taylor that describes everything you just saw today with details, links, and pointers. So you can repro that, reuse this kind of solution. Taylor, thanks a lot for your time today. Hope to see you soon on the IoT show, right?
Thanks for having me on the show.
Always, you're more than welcome. Thanks, everyone, for tuning in. See you soon. Bye-bye.